Hi guys, I'm Shreema Rai and I'm with celebrity drape artist Dolly Jane, and we're at Pernia's pop-up studio today, and we want to show you guys some fun ways to drape a sari.
And this sari that we picked up from is from Varun Dal, and it's a beautiful sari, and I'm going to show you how you can wear this sari with a beautiful blouse, like a sleeveless blouse that he has, and a black denim. I mean, instead of using a petticoat, you can use a denim, on this. And okay, I start by making my upper pleats. Like normally what we do is we start draping from tucking in here, but this drape starts from your shoulder pleats. So this is how you make your shoulder pleats. So this, okay. And you keep pegging it up. I mean, just hold these, take the support of these pegs and clasp them, and you can just make your pleats. Keep using these pegs. I would really advise you not to use safety pins. Instead of that, use these pegs, because when you use safety pins, you unnecessarily make so many holes in the sari, which is,
and
like
it ruins the sari.
I mean, this is such a delicate fabric. Imagine if you've torn the sari, it's gone.
Exactly.
So yeah. So to just save time, I've just made pleats. So I'm just going to show you. After you've done the pleats, just rest this on your shoulders. Okay. So the pleats are resting on your shoulders. I like it long enough, because when you have your palla long, you have, you know, fabric enough to play around with. If you think this is too long and you want to leave it without taking it in your arms or that, something like that, what you can do is you can even keep it short. But at present, I'm keeping it long because I really want to show you some drama with this. Okay, after this, what you do is just take this and tuck this in here. So you have like a cowl, like a, you know, a cowl kind of thing here. Same thing, you go from back, and now instead of pleating it like this, I mean this way, like normally I've seen what you do is you pleat it this way, but instead of pleating it this way, pleat it the, you know, like the width wise, instead of pleating it lengthwise. So you just take this and you pleat it. So yeah, so once you've done these pleats, like if you can see what I've done is, take this and tuck it right below your navel, like this, and then you have to leave the same amount of cowl that you've left on the other side. This, if you can see, this cowl and this cowl has to be equal, okay? And now you turn around. So this, hold this.
Okay.
So this is the fabric which is left. Okay, now what you do is hold them together and start making pleats together. So you fold them and make pleats. It's this. And according to the length, just take this and tuck this inside and drop this down. And yeah, your drape is done. Now to just enhance this, what you can do is you can use a waist belt. I mean, once you use a waist belt, it looks really beautiful. And with this long palla, I mean, see, sometimes I really feel like trailing the whole sari, but if you don't wish to, what you can do is just take this and hold it in your arms. Like, you know, just hold it. See, even that looks nice. Suppose you're not planning to wear anything on this, you know,
on this wrist,
yeah.
You can just sort of,
you can
stylize
just,
it,
yeah,
that way.
Just hold it that way,
yeah.
And you know, you can just wear your watch that side. I think this looks really nice. And if you think that you know, your back is too bare and you want to cover it, so you can just take this instead of this side. You can put the whole thing on this side. Hold this. Yeah.
Okay, and then it covers the back.
See, it just covers the back. and the whole drape is there. So I hope you've understood this drape. It's pretty easy to do it. It's just by 2-3 ways of pleating it up. The trick is to pleat it nicely and secure it with pins. And the rest I'm always there to teach you.